CPU is brain of our computers. It has billions of transistors. But how they are made? First, there are design of circuit diagrams. Using some hardware description language, like Verilog, new digital circuits can be actually written in code and tested using simulation. The manufacturing itself starts with production of silicon. We can get silicon from sand by heating it to thousands of degrees. This gives us a block of pure silicon. The block is then cut into extremely thin layers called wafers. Wafers must be completely dust-free, so the working environment is cleaner than operating theater. Using photolithography, circuit structure is transferred to the wafers. Single wafer can fit hundreds of CPUs. Parts exposed to UV light are washed out, leaving a pattern that is further etched with another machines. After the photolithography, we move on to the doping using ion implantation. Doping is process of adding tiny impurities in order to change electrical properties of silicon. Transistors are born and we can move to the next phase, connecting them together. Whole surface is filled with copper. The excess copper is polished away and transistor openings are connected with copper wires. The final product is wafer with hundreds of billions of transistors and very complex network of circuits with length of many kilometers. The last step is packaging. Wafer is diced, chips are bonded to the frame and covered with heat spreader. And here it is, ready to use CPU. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe to see more videos like this in future.